Here we are with a Mirrodin Besieged, Scars of Mirrodin, 4-3-2-2. And first pack, we're looking at, you know, not a whole lot. We've got Steel Sabotage, Rusted Slasher is fine too, Sky Hunter if you want to jump on the white bandwagon early, but obviously the first pick here is going to be Flame Fiend. He's removal, he's a 4-4. He's just so much better than anything else that's in this pack. So, starting off with the Flame Fiend. It's not a terrible place to begin. Second pick. Ooh. Here we've got some choices. So, you could just go with the super conservative Blister Six Shaman. After you've taken Kadoth the Flame Fiend, you would definitely be able to play Blister Six Shaman in your deck. But then again, I think Spine of Ish-Sar is a much more powerful card than Blister Six Shaman. Come as well with Kadoth Flame Fiend, and I think is just a stronger card. 7 is pretty expensive, but once you get to 7, if you can get a recurring spine going, I have won out many games like that. Fraction Juggernaut, fine as well. Rotwolf's good as well, though Rotwolf following a Flame Fiend, not much interaction with the cards there. But yeah, I'm going to go with the spine. If you're not sold on the spine, then hopefully I'll have some games to demonstrate the power of the spine. Here we've got Morbid Plunder, a fine card returning Flame Fiends and whatnot. Blight Widow, also a good card. So this, I think those are the only two worth considering at this stage. So between Blight Widow and Morbid Plunder. So Morbid Plunder is a bit of a tougher pick because it's double black, does require me to get some good stream of black cards coming around. Returning Flame Fiend does sound pretty tasty with Morbid Plunder, but it might be just a bit too greedy when green-black should be much more reliable to get cards to fill out the deck, and Blight Widow easier to splash in as well, and it is a fine splash. Being able to block flies, which can be a problem depending on how your deck is set up. Here we've got Lumengrid Gargoyle. We've also got Peace Strider, and then the rest not really a consideration at this stage. I think I'm going to go with the Peace Strider here. He does a fine job, comes in as an artifact, gains you 3 life. Lumengrid Gargoyle, I'm not going to fault him, but I think I just like Peace Strider a little bit better. Other cards, well, later down the track, I'd be happy to take cards like This Is Courier, and maybe even Kadoth the Ringleader. Flare Husk, I guess I don't mind taking either. Here we've got, in green and red, Tangle Hulk, probably the only consideration here. So if I had gone with taking black over green, Scourge Serpent, not so exciting. Tangle Hulk, on the other hand, bit better. Of course, if you are going with the Infect deck, then you know, a 3-3 Infect isn't the worst, but Tangle Hulk, just in general, is a stronger card. Alrighty. So, here's some cards. I think Spin Engine being the best in the colours we've got going. Although, Foily Priest of Norn, I do like that. But not in white. In green and red, Spin Engine, Glissus Courier, Nathasaur, and that's the order I would put them in as far as picks, and Spin Engine at the top. So, here, a whole lot going on. These green instant spells, not terribly exciting. Especially when green red, you generally end up with big monsters anyways. The pump spell is much more exciting when you've got Infect going on. So, I think the picks here between Flare Husk and maybe, well, Hexblade and Nathasaur, I guess. They're about the same. I think Hexblade's better than Nathasaur. But I'll I'll take the Flare Husk here. Not likely to need it in a green-red dinosaur kind of deck, but much better than a Hex Plate for the deck anyways. Not too keen on loading up my 7-drops just yet. Here, Pistol Strike, find card forward sideboard, of course. Oh, and here's another 7-drop. Quilt Slag Worm, a bit better than a Hexplate Golem. And Psychosis Crawler, just pretty underwhelming for 5 mana. You have to pay 5 mana for that? Not very excited about it. Okay, so not much going on for the rest of the pack, perhaps. Let's just take, I don't know, Mirror Spy. It flies. There's got to be some value in flying. Ooh, Gruesome Encore. I think we'll just take this Scourge Servant here. As white infect cards, not much of a threat. And Shriekhorns, not much either. Yeah, let's just take these lands here. Okay, so out of the first pack, Godolphin Flame Fiend, Blight Widow, quite strong. Spin Engine and Peace Strider, nice cards to have in your deck. And Spine, very swingy, but definitely worth its mana cost, being able to destroy anything with the potential to come back, especially when you've got red in your deck. Plenty of red guys that are sacrificing artifacts, and you can set up multiple recursions with Spine. Here we are in the next pack, and Spikeshot Elder. Spikeshot Elder will make this Flare Husk playable, I guess. Though it would be nice to pick up a Darksteel Axe to go with him. Not much else in the pack. A Foily Molder Beast I would be happy to play if it came back around the table. Otherwise, more likely I'll just be taking an Azuri's Archer, and that's fine as well. But Spikeshot Elder, pretty fine first pick, especially when I'm in solidly sitting in red. So, Ferrovor. Combos nicely with Spine of Ishtar, but no reason to take him just yet. When there's better cards to take over him, like Trigon of Corruption. As much as I'd love to, just completely ditch green and go for Volition Reigns. Well, I guess that's not completely out of the question. I'd have to get rid of Blight Widow, Tanglehawk, and Quilled Slagworm. So I would be sacrificing. I would be sacrificing Blight Widow for Volition Reigns, because I'm not really too worried about these other guys. Now that I think about it, I think that's worth it. Alright, let's go with the Volition Reigns then. Okay, so of course, sliding back into green is always an option. Since there's no blue, and I don't really need to take Sableclaw Golem here. Not when there's a Wall of Tanglequad, which is pretty nice. So, Wall of Tanglequad is just better than anything else at this stage. Even if I'm not going to have green in the deck, well, yeah, if Volition Reigns is in the deck, then I'm probably not going to be playing Blight Widow, but Wall of Tanglequad still could be playable without green in the deck. Also, I could be siding in green if my opponent's deck is Heavy Flies. Here we've got a pretty nice Galvanic Blast, and look at those infect guys going around. Alright, and Shatter's another nice card as well. Green's not very exciting, and blue's not very exciting either. So, not much signaling I can really make use of. There's still a Disperse here, but I can't really call that a signal. But I will take the Disperse. Disperse being much more exciting than anything else in that pack. So jumping on the blue bandwagon might be worth the cost. So I think it's between Panic Spellbomb and Strider Harness, which will mostly just increase the artifact count. And I'm not sure how much value I'm going to get out of this Strider Harness just yet, but Panic Spellbomb, getting an early artifact, having another artifact to sacrifice to Flame Fiend. Not sure about the creature fronts after I hide these green guys, what I'll have. So giving up blockability might lose a bit of value there. So Molder Beast is here, but since I've moved away from that for the power of Volition Reigns, I guess Blade Tribe Berserkers is still fine. Neuroconvizomancer is still an option though. Well, can't go too far wrong with a Hill Giant, I would say. And sure, I'll take a Spell Bomb. Let's hide this Flight Spell Bomb. Of course, I could side in a Flight Spell Bomb against Flyers as well. There we go, there's a nice late Fervor to match up with Spine of Ishtar quite nicely. Sure, Ogre Gear Grabber is on colour, but also isn't very exciting, so he's going to get hit. Another Fervor. Not sure if I'll play two, but I definitely want to play at least one to go with the Spine. Because destroying a permanent every turn is just too powerful to pass up. So, triple blue. I would like to see some more blue cards coming around to justify this triple blue cast. Although, yeah, if you have mono red splash blue for triple blue, So yes, I would like to see a few more blue cards. Although the red cards, they're coming on thick and fast. So, Arctrail and Turtleslag, both fine removal cards, but Arctrail just kills two things, so we're going to go with that. And Turtleslag, hopefully pick up another one later, because that would be nice too. As far as removal, Galvanic Blast, Spike Shot, Shatter, and Arctrail, and Spine of Ishtar, so we're not short of removal, but another Turtleslag would be a good option too. Scrap Melter, that would be a good option as well. So, Scrap Melter just beating out anything else in this pack. If the Scrap Melter wasn't there, Forge Master, I guess. I'd take the Forge Master and hope that I could get enough artifacts that I could forge out Spine of Ishtar. That'd be a cool play. But Scrap Melter is there, and Scrap Melter is the bomb. So, here we've got pretty much artifacts we're looking at. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 artifacts in the deck so far. So not so many. So Chrome Steed, not so exciting. Stempclaw Golem, I think, is going to be stronger than anything else here. Since, well, there aren't many cards that lend themselves to aggressive or defensive. I mean, well, if I've got one Ferrovor in the deck, I might use him defensively if I've got Spine of Ishtar. Spin Engine is more aggressive, but then when you've just got Hill Giants and things, I mean, they could be offensive or defensive. So, I'm not particularly drawn to Clone Shell for that reason. I'm not the defensive deck. But Saberclaw Golem, I mean, he can sit back on the D, he can attack, those sorts of things. So, here, got some top choices. Lumengrid Drake, not terribly likely to get Metalcraft at this stage, I don't think. But what other options are there? Clone Shell, again, well, I guess Clone Shell does up the artifact count. Does combo with Flame Fiend if I pick up a Barrage Ogre. And Ferrovor. Yeah, I guess Clone Shell isn't the worst, because Lumengrid Drake isn't that exciting. Silver Glass stuff, again, not very exciting either. Pumps up Spike Shell Elder, but otherwise it's pretty lame. So, Clone Shell I'll go with here. So, Bladed Pinions, I guess that's the only option, I guess. Sirtak, not going to get Metalcraft going very reliably. Bladed Pinions on my Heal Giants isn't terribly exciting, but, well, I guess I can sit back and block Flyers if need be. And Unblockability isn't the worst. So, that's a fairly late Rusted Relic. The thing is, can I get Metalcraft for it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and that'll bring me up to 10. I think the power level of Rusted Relic it's worth a shot. It's worth a shot. The only other option, I guess, well, Necrotid Sensor is an option. Not very good one, I don't think. In this deck, Flameborn Hellion is an option, but Rusted Relic is just powerful enough. So, here we've got another artifact in Darksteel Sentinel, or Gold Mirror is a choice as well. Do I need the Gold Mirror? So, powering out these four drops is fine. Gold Mirror or Darksteel Sentinel? I guess, yeah. Darksteel Sentinel is strong. Nah, I'm gonna go with Darksteel Sentinel. I mean, it's better than Gold Mirror, power level wise. And I'm not looking like I'm gonna be in a hurry to get to my later drops. I can use removal liberally in the early turns of the game to keep my life total looking good. So, Soliton or Bonds? Bonds being an unexciting removal spell and Soliton being an unexciting creature. I guess I'll just take the removal spell. Ah, there we go, there's a nice Volshock replica, fits into the curve quite nicely. I'm not excited about another 5 drops, so I've got these 6 drops as well. But a 3 drop, I am happy about, and Hold Order or Oxida Daredevil. Oxida Daredevil, well, he could come down early as a blocker, since I haven't got that many low drops, but Hold Order I'm more likely to actually play. Alright, so Lumen Grid Drake again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, so I've got more now. That I might take the Lumen Grid Drake and I can play it instead of Bonds of Quicksilver, that might be better. And sure, another one, why not? So, provided I can get Metalcraft going and then these Lumen Grid Drakes. Not sure what the chances of that are. But Lumen Grid Drakes being more exciting when you've got Metalcraft than Blade Tribe Berserkers, I would say. For this deck at least, which has got really strong late game stuff. So, yeah, I don't think I was really passing up much green, and certainly Volition Reigns is too strong to be passing up. Let's put in these Lumen Grid Drakes. And disperse? Nah, Hold Order. So I might need Flight Spell Bomb for Metalcraft, in fact. Might be more exciting than Bladed Pinions, I would say. Alright, so plenty of artifacts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, yep. 12's a good number, and getting these good low drops to get these drakes going and whatnot. So I want at least one Ferrovor, get my removal going, Flame Fiend of course, Galvanic Blast, and Scrap Melter, and that's 23, and I'm not missing anything that's left in the sideboard. I mean, I've got Bonds, I've got, well, a second Ferrovor, which isn't terribly exciting. Blade Tribe, they're all cards that could go into the deck, and Bladed Pinions, so I'm leaving them behind, and I'm not too sad about that. If I come across plenty of flyers in an opponent's deck, I could side in for green, and that's always an option for Pistol Strike and Light Widow. But yeah, as it stands, not a bad red-blue deck. So just 8 and 9, with more red than blue. So let's go by colour. Okay, that's interesting. Yeah, okay, 8 and 9. I think that's fair, actually. Most of these red spells are removal anyway, so I shouldn't need them too early on. Yeah, so 8 and 9. Go with that, have another look. Yep, looks pretty good to me. Good removals, got some good bombs. Should be alright. Let's go with this.